The world will note that the first atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, a military base. We won the race of discovery against the Germans. We have used it in order to shorten the agony of war, in order to save the lives of thousands and thousands of young Americans. We shall continue to use it until we completely destroy Japan's power to make war.
August 6, 1945, 8:15 a.m., United States bomber plane the Enola Gay dropped an atomic bomb on Hiroshima, Japan. An estimated over 70,000 killed immediately, and another 70,000 killed in the hours, days, weeks, and months after the attack. 3 days later, another United States bomber plane, B-29, nicknamed the Boxcar, dropped another bomb on Nagasaki, Japan. This bomb killed another 75,000 people. The events that occurred in the years before the bombing determined the fate of Japan, trailing back to when Japan committed an attack against the United States in 1941. 4 years prior to the drop of the atomic bomb, on December 7, 1941, Japanese planes dropped bombs on a United States naval base at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii. The bombing killed over 2,300 Americans, injured over 1,000, and completely demolished the American battleships stationed there. The attack on Pearl Harbor forced the United States into World War II. The United States fought for a way to end the war by taking out the antagonizing forces. That meant taking away Japan's ability to continue fighting in the war. Before the United States entered the war and before the attack on Pearl Harbor, the United States was already taking actions towards ending the war. After hearing of Germany's possible success in creating nuclear weapons, Albert Einstein and Leo Szilard sent President Roosevelt a letter warning of the possible bomb. As a response to hearing this, President Roosevelt started the Uranium Committee, which did research on nuclear reactions. The success of the Uranium Committee led to the creation of a larger research and engineering project called the Manhattan Project, which earned its name after the city the research originated in. Prior to U.S. entry into the war, the progress made in the Manhattan Project was only research-based and no nuclear weapons were created. However, after the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor, scientists working on the Manhattan Project took the research they had gathered and put it to use in developing the United States' first nuclear weapons. Combining the research from secret facilities across the United States, the first bomb was created in a main research facility in the desert near Los Alamos, New Mexico. The first atomic bomb was detonated on July 16, 1945, in Alamogordo, Gordo, New Mexico. This test is known as the Trinity Test and showed scientists the power of nuclear weapons. The Trinity Test created a mushroom cloud of ash that reached 40,000 feet in the air. Cities over 50 miles away felt the impact of the Trinity bomb. With a new understanding of how deadly nuclear weapons were, the Manhattan Project continued to create and test more atomic bombs. Some tests were performed underwater to reduce the impact of radiation, others in the desert away from towns. The United States was confident with the atomic bomb that emerged from the Manhattan Project and was prepared to use it to end World War II. However, although the bomb was ready for use, there was a lot of debate to be held before the atomic bomb would be dropped on Japan. After President Roosevelt's death on April 12, 1945, Vice President Harry Truman took his place. When Truman came into office, he was informed with the progress of the Manhattan Project. This left him with an enormous decision to make. An atomic bomb was created and ready for use. He could give the order to use it against Japan to end World War II, but the price would be the lives of thousands of citizens. The other options President Truman considered included invading Japan from the ground, giving a demonstration of the atomic bomb on an uninhabited area to threaten Japan into surrendering, or continuing the use of conventional bombing, meaning dropping non-nuclear bombs on Japan. All options had the goal of causing Japan to surrender and therefore end World War II. When asked about his decision, Truman explained that he chose to drop the atomic bomb on an inhabited Japanese city because it was most likely to cause Japan to surrender. He also described that if the atomic bombs would not have been dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the war would not have come to an end, and as a result, more Japanese and American soldiers and civilians would die than the amount killed by the bomb. Truman's ultimate decision to release the atomic bomb on Japan is a topic still debated today. People question what the outcome would have been if the atomic bomb was not used, and how society would look today if his decision was different. Historians and critics debate whether the positive outcome, the end to World War II, outweighed all the negative effects of the use of the most deadly bomb known to mankind.
Some short-term effects of the atomic bomb are that 70,000 people died immediately after the bombing of Hiroshima, and another 75,000 killed after the second atomic bomb was dropped on Nagasaki. Almost half the total number of deaths of the bombing occurred on the first day after the atomic bomb was dropped, and took 20 to 30 minutes for radiation to cause any kind of death at all. 45 minutes after 8:15 a.m., the blast of the black rain, or highly radioactive particles, started falling. And in 3 to 6 weeks after the bombing, most people with severe radiation symptoms died. About 70% of the buildings were destroyed at this time, and 42 out of 45 hospitals were destroyed as well, and couldn't get to the victims of the bombing. Some long-term effects of the atomic bomb are that the radiation from the bomb made the risk for thyroid, lung, and breast cancer increase, but no health effect of any sort has been detected among the children of the survivors so far. People still struggle to this day to find employment, and the effects on the environment include total destruction of plants and wildlife in the city that were bombed. People feared it would become a wasteland. Between 90,000 and 166,000 people are believed to have died from the bomb in the first 4 months period following the explosion. The U.S. Department of Energy has estimated that after 5 years, there were perhaps 200,000 deaths or more fatalities. As a result of the bombing, while the city of Hiroshima has estimated about 237,000 people were killed directly or indirectly by the bomb's effects, including burns, radiation sickness, and cancer.